Putin's humiliation. Belgrade Oblast attacks. This is what we're going to talk about today. Hello there, I'm Elina and this is my channel Enough. Enough of propaganda. And enough of lots of other things, like enough of stupidity. But not on from Russian side, at least. I don't think could be enough of stupidity there. And Ukraine really need Russian army and their commanders to be stupid. Which we will talk about today and we will prove it. And that's what we're gonna discuss. The attacks on Belgrade region prove that Russia can't defend its own territories. Russian Volunteer Corps and the Legion of Freedom of Russia are back to Russia, fighting in Belgrade region. And as they claim, the town Novaya Tavoljanka is under their control. And we will see that all in this video. And Putin is hiding from shame. I don't see much Putin proudly saying how wonderful they're dealing with the attacks on Russian territory. Good one. This is a little bit older article from Medusa from 23rd of May 2023. It says authorities, it means Russian authorities, a little bit forgot that our region is also Russia, part of Russia. And local people wasn't happy before when basically Russian citizens came to the territory of Belgrade region from Ukraine. Military unit basically took over the Russian territory, invaded nuclear country, which is their own country, and took part of the territory and hold it for 24 hours and then successfully left, but now they are back. But Belgrade region isn't happy and wasn't happy. And at the time they were saying that authorities couldn't admit that they are, how to say politely, poop themselves. And so on. I have another video about this on my channel, just previous video about talking about this kind of part of invasion. But today we're gonna talk about a new one. Since June 1st, basically, it's all going on in Russia. And the governor of Belgrade region, this is Medusa again, or Belgrade Oblast, said that authorities cannot come into the town Novaya Tavoljanka. And the Russian Volunteer Corps is saying that they're controlling the town. And so Vyacheslav Gladkov, the governor of Belgrade region, confirmed that. And that's what he says. He said during a live stream in a group of ВКонтакте and responding on the questions of local people. And this article was from 5th of June. He said, I quote, "Today we kinda can't come inside of the town yet, knowing that about 100 people there used to stay. According to the chief of the district, there are 100 people still there. But the shelling of the last 2 days cannot allow us to confirm that information. I hope that as soon as the situation will change, we will come back to talking to people and convince them to leave this town." And he didn't confirm why the authorities cannot enter the Russian town in Russian Federation. And Russian Volunteer Corps, as I said, said that they're controlling the town. Basically, they had several so-called visits to Belgrade region. And by 4th of June, they said about new attack. And that's how they ended up in Novaya Tavoljanka town. And this is what Russian Volunteer Corps has to say. They've been in control of the village for a long time. That's what they are saying. They posted video today, and actually several Russian channels confirmed that they were there, while they were filming.
Ну что ж, друзья, бойцы русского добровольческого корпуса, который день контролирует населенный пункт Новая Таволяжанка. Хочу напомнить всем гражданам России, что это не какое-то маленькое заброшенное село, а населенный пункт в 5000 человек. Сейчас он пуст, здесь находятся только бойцы русского добровольческого корпуса. Другой власти в этом регионе нет. Раз господин Гладков не может контролировать свою подшефную территорию, мы будем разговаривать только с его руководителями, которые находятся в Москве.
So basically they talking about that Mr. Gladkov can't control his territory. And they are in Novaya Tavoljanka, which is 5,000 people city. This is the information I found, contradicting Russian propaganda about that the Polish fighters from Polish Volunteer Corps are fighting on the territory of Russian Federation together with Russian Volunteer Corps and Legion of Freedom of Russia. This is not true, and Russian Volunteer Corps disproved it and said this is not the case.
Официально РДК опровергла участие поляков в военных действиях на территории России.
Что касается боевых действий на территории Российской Федерации, бойцы ПДК обеспечивают конвой пленных, военную и медицинскую логистику, но только в пределах государственной границы Украины.
According to Polish authorities, Polish Volunteer Corps, which described in media, absolutely not connected to any Polish military or any Polish authorities. Also, there are several videos how people from Russian Volunteer Corps and Legion of Freedom of Russia are capturing Russian soldiers, like this one. And there are several others. This is what Russian soldier has to say.
Дорогие друзья, я обычный солдат вооруженных сил Российской Федерации. Меня зовут Владимир Иванович Шмелев, 138-я бригада, рядовой. До вчерашнего дня мы находились в Белгородской области на границе с Украиной. Потом начался сильнейший артобстрел наших позиций, вплоть до Химросов этих и Бучих. Нам была дана команда сидеть на позициях, что мы и сделали. После этого, спустя пару часов, начал заходить укропы, да хуя укропов. Мы отстреливались от них и пытались дать им отпор, но их было слишком много. Мы запросили приказ наступления, но нам дали отказ. В результате мы потеряли около 80% личного состава и вынуждены были уйти из позиций собственными силами без приказа и подкрепления. Мы оставили границу. Спустя некоторое время ситуация сложилась так, что подобное произошло еще с двумя группами.
You can watch the whole thing. If you like, I'll give you the link. What I can say, where are the 22,000? A Russian army man who's supposed to defend Russian borders, I wonder. If Putin wouldn't have started the war in Ukraine, first of all, nobody would have attacked Russian border in the first place, and second of all, the troops would be there in case some aliens will show up and try to attack Russia. Nobody was attacking Russia before Putin started the war in Ukraine in 2014. And this guy, all sniveling about this and blaming his commander, Colonel Colchin. We will remember that name too for the future war trials. And this is the translation on the Twitter of Anton Gerashenko from Ukraine. What's the mood about among Russian bloggers and war correspondents, so-called? This is the original text. It said Rosich. It says, I'm sitting in F shock. The situation in the country is F up. They only destabilizing it further. The situation in Belgorod region is getting worse. The Minister of Defense almost entered into an open confrontation with Wagner. Wagner has a confrontation with Ahmad, which is Kadyrov's forces. They don't let us work at full strength. On the waiting list, drones fly over Moscow. They fly into Krasnodar, systematically visit Crimea. Everyone fights with each other. Even Telegram channels. How are we going to win like that? I can tell you how. You're not gonna win. Nothing distinguished Russia from other countries as much as competition and hostility of various structures to each other. The problem is deeper and deeper. People argue with each other in grocery stores, shops, military arguing their locations. There is arguing between the types of military forces, arguing between structures. Everyone F argues. I not pronounce F words, but you're welcome to read it if you like. So, after Russian Volunteer Corps had entered Russian territory and there was fights in there, and meanwhile Russia was shelling them and shooting chemical basically weapons using in the Russian territory, shooting at Belgorod region, and it was filmed, and it was proved, and so on. Russian volunteer corps happened to have several people as prisoners of war. And what happened? They offered Mr. Gladkov, the governor of Belgorod Oblast, Belgorod region, to exchange those people, to come onto, basically, at first they had about 2 prisoners, I think, and they wanted to exchange them for just a few hours of conversation, a few minutes of conversation with governor of the Belgorod region. They invited him to come to them in the church, and they said, we'll just give those people back to you.
Я командир русского добровольческого корпуса. Рядом со мной представитель Легиона Свободы России. С другой стороны, наши пленные. Мы находимся недалеко от новой Таложанки, и сейчас они скажут вам пару слов. Род войск.
He is saying that me and the chief of Legion of Free Russia Legion, we are near Novaya Tavolozhanka, and these your prisoners, your soldiers, and they will tell you a couple words.
Имя, фамилия. Алексей Беляев. Звание старший лейтенант. Откуда родом? Кашетевская.
So they kind of telling their names and so on. So basically they offered to exchange. I guess they knew the governor wouldn't go for it. First of all, he isn't the right person to do that type of stuff. And second of all, he wouldn't be even allowed from Kremlin or from FSB or something to do that. In my opinion, the governor is a coward. If he is the governor and he gets an offer like that, he didn't care to go and liberate these people. His Russian soldiers captured by invaders. In my opinion, liberators, in somebody other opinion, invaders. The governor refused. He basically said, you come here, or something like that. He tried to switch the places and this and that. He wasn't intended to go and liberate people. He said, I presume they're already dead. So the fight continued. And eventually, these guys captured more Russian soldiers. And actually, the channel We Can Explain, it called Find Out the Names of the People. It's Roman Gomenyuk, Dmitry Ermakov, Alexey Belyaev, Vilimov Denis, Yuri Martynov, Alexey Khamitsky. So they all were identified. They are real people, Russian soldiers. But the governor still didn't want to exchange or do anything about this. The last 2 pieces I'm showing it's from TV Rain. This is the coward Governor Gladkov of Belgorod region. That's what he has to say.
Увидел обращение подлецов, негодяев, убийцы, фашистов.
He saw the video of the bad guys and murderers and fascists, he calling the people who came to liberate Russian people, basically. And this is what he's saying. He's saying that the only thing which stopping me to dealing with them, just I'm thinking that our boys, which is these guys captured, they probably already dead. Well, he just saw the video, they were alive. Previous video, you can watch it in full, so the people were alive. One guy was covered by the blanket, he was kind of wounded. And now they have even more prisoners.
Мне тяжело было это говорить. Но если они живые, с 17 до 18, мав Шебекина.
But if they're still alive, we could meet here in Shebekina. It's another town near Belgorod, also shelled by Russian army. And eventually he didn't show up.
Честь имею, Евгений Викторович. Я Цезарь, представитель Легиона Свобода России. Как нам стало известно, бойцами ЧВК «Вагнер» был взят в плен командир 72-й бригады ВСРФ подполковник Роман Веневитин. Как вы уже знаете, у нас в плену находятся десятки военнослужащих российской армии и пограничников. Мы предлагали отдать их без каких-то дополнительных условий, просто в качестве жеста доброй воли. Но кавалер Ордена Мужества, губернатор Вячеслав Гладков, на заявленную встречу не явился. А тем временем продолжаются немотивированные обстрелы армии России, территории Шебекина и Новой Таволжанки. Мы слышали о вас, Евгений Викторович, что вы говорили, что даже к противнику нужно относиться с уважением. И мы считаем, что вы тот самый человек, с которым мы можем говорить и договариваться. Мы предлагаем вам обменять подполковника Романа Веневитина на бойцов российской армии и пограничников, которые находятся у нас в плену.
Basically, he's talking to Prigozhin. And Prigozhin, like Russians would call it, he's a cork in every bottle. Want to be a cork in every bottle. So, trying to stick his nose everywhere. When, basically, governor Gladkov wasn't really keen on exchanging prisoners, Prigozhin offered himself, like, he said he will send some sort of his high command officer to exchange those prisoners of war. And if President Zelensky will show up, then Prigozhin will come in person. It was before this offer. But now, basically, the rebels offering to exchange some prisoners and border guards to that captured Russian military officer Veniviten. Russian Freedom Legion, finally, when they understood that the governor of Belgorod region wouldn't show up, they said that they would like to exchange, a few people have exchanged with maybe Prigozhin instead. And they wanted to exchange this man, Lieutenant Colonel Veniviten from 72 Brigade. That's what they proposed to Prigozhin. Eventually, Caesar understood that it's useless to talk to Gladkov because he doesn't control his territory. So now they wanted to talk to Moscow. We will see what's gonna happen later about that, but now I can show you some footage of shelling Belgorod. Some sort of blow-ups happened.
Opa.
Opa. So this is the result of Putin's genius plan to start the war in Ukraine. Now Russian cities getting shot at, and many of them get shot by Russian army itself. So let's see what Russian propagandist has to say.
Я полностью соглашаюсь с губернатором Гладковым. Радикально решить вопрос о защите нашей территории может только решительным разгромом группировки ВСУ в районе Харькова.
Ощущение, что у нас просто недостаточно концентрация сил на Белгородчине. В этой связи мы не пошли туда.
У меня такого впечатления нету.
Then he's wrong. If they could have taken Kharkiv region, they would have. They just can't. Russian army can't do it. This is channel first, Russian first channel, and they said it's online, like a live stream, which is, I doubt. It never happened in USSR, and right now, of course, they're gonna leave live stream. People might say something which isn't appropriate or approved.
Там нет никого.
Почему? Там есть. Во-первых, начнем с того, что там есть войска прикрытия границы, которые, в принципе, эту задачу решить могут. Это...
Oh yeah, why they didn't solve it by now? Where are those 22,000 troops who are supposed to be on Russian border? I would like to know where they are.
Раз. Во-вторых, в такой ситуации, если идет вот такие вот действия, значит, естественно, должны быть наращиваться силы. Да, путем переброски с других
Конечно,
направлений.
Конечно, этого Возможно, добиваются даже... украинцы.
Да,
Конечно.
От этого деваться некуда. Ну а как? Мы должны защищать людей. Это наша конституционная обязанность. Вот, и решить этот вопрос. Наконец, я могу сказать еще.
Это просто к тому, что группа прикрытия границы не способна заходить в Харьковскую область.
Of course they are incapable. Because they are not even there. They are fighting the war in Ukraine. Aggressive war Putin started. That's why they can't protect Russian borders. That's why somebody even attacking Russian borders in the first place. This is interesting that even Russian propagandists started to understand that Russia cannot defend its borders. This is what Mykhailo Podolyak has to say, the advisor of President of Ukraine. He is saying that many people have fair questions. What exactly is happening in the Belgorod Oblast now? It is simple. A classic boomerang. In fact, today's disputed territories, a gray zone, which is there is a confrontation between Putin's army and Russian volunteer corps, active Russian citizens who don't agree with Moscow genocidal policy and enjoy the support of the local population. That is the battle of the Russian Goliath and Russian David. Ukraine is not involved in this conflict. We are watching the course of hostilities once again, call on the Moscow regime to cease fire in the Belgorod Oblast immediately, sit down at the negotiating table with Russian volunteer corps and stop the senseless bloodshed. Otherwise, number of disputed territories will grow rapidly. I agree with that. I know, well, I don't know, but I presume that Ukraine aware That's what happening, and Podolyak isn't hiding that. It is beneficial to Ukraine that Russian territory get attacked, and now Russian troops would be has to come back from the front in Ukraine and defend Russian borders in Belgorod region. Hopefully, it will make a future counteroffensive of Ukraine easier. But I don't think Ukraine would directly and exactly get involved. And as far as I know, every volunteers who fighting in Ukraine, which Russian Volunteer Corps as well did fighting in Ukraine, so is Russian Liberty of Russia Legion. They are, as far as I know, everybody who fighting in Ukraine, no matter from what country they are, they signing a contract, they becoming Ukrainian city, the Ukrainian army, part of Ukrainian army. But as far as I heard many statements from Ukrainian officials that in Russia, those Russian citizens acting on their own accord, which is beneficial to Ukraine, of course. But again, Russia had it coming. And in fact, looking at the situation in Russian territory, it really simply reminds me the Crimea in 2014. That's how Russia did it. That's how Russia sent their troops into only this is Russian citizens coming to Russia. In the case of Crimea, it was Russian citizens coming to the independent country of Ukraine and started a war there. It's not that similar, but it has some similarities. If Putin opened the case, the box of Pandora box, then what did he expect didn't happen? So now basically they stole the card out of his deck and even played with it, put it on the table. So, and even that Russian Volunteer Corps basically said there's gonna be a referendum about Belgorod region maybe want to secede from Russia. That would be funny to watch. Not funny, but I mean, Russian citizens invaded Crimea, and I just finished a whole bunch of videos about that in detail in the playlist War in Ukraine 2014. I'm showing you exactly how it was happening with proofs and facts and videos and stuff like that. So now Putin could enjoy what's happening in his own country. It was his fault. He had it coming. And in the end of the video, a little bit of funny things. This is from Operator Starsky. I watch him on YouTube quite a bit. He says this is the moment when a fleeing citizen of Belgorod notices a marauder or a looter snatched his toilet that was previously snatched in Kherson. It's talking about that Russian army was looting and marauding in Ukraine, stealing toilets, literally. And this is what that joke is about. And the last joke is, tell me in one word how the war is going. Gerasimov, good. Tell me in two words, Shoigu, not good. This is what's happening, and this is the update. And please help Ukraine. Please arm Ukraine and help Ukraine win this war. Because this is the best thing which can happen to Russia, is get rid of Putin and his regime. While Putin is in power, there would be no stable peace in Europe ever. As soon as Putin is out of power, there is a hope for it. Not until then. Thank you for watching and have a great evening.